and honor, glory and power, be unto the Ancient of Days.
From every nation,
from every nation,
all of creation,
all of creation, bow before thee.
I want to speak to you again on wisdom makes life, not a living. Then I want to begin again by asking a question. What if I despise wisdom from above and instruction from above? How about if you despise the wisdom from above? And the instruction from above. How would your life look
on you?
Amen.
Amen.
Apostle Paul writing to believers in the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 17. He says that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him. That's a prayer of an apostle to the believers. He says that the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the knowledge of Him, may be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of His calling, and then you enjoy the riches of His glory. Amen.
Amen.
Paul is talking of wisdom, and he's praying that the believers may receive the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him. So, who gives us wisdom? God gives us wisdom. And this wisdom comes in the knowledge of knowing who God is. Who is God to you? That wisdom is simply applying knowledge to solve life situations. And so as we study wisdom, I want you not to lean onto your own understanding, or refer to your intellect. But I want you to listen to your spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because God will speak to your spirit. And when God speaks to your spirit, He releases knowledge and understanding. And that knowledge and understanding activate the wisdom of God. Then your heart will lead your intellect. And so you will no longer be led by what you see, but you will be led by the Spirit of God. Can you say amen to that? In Proverbs 1 verse 7, he says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Fools despise wisdom and instruction. I don't want to be called a fool. I want to be called the wisdom of God. Because wisdom of God. But this foolishness has nothing to do with your educational background. Are you following what I'm saying?
Yes.
It has nothing to do with your IQ. It has nothing to do with whether you went to school or not. I'm in no way despising education. Education is okay. But I want you to understand the wisdom I'm talking about. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And so when you despise wisdom and instruction from the word of God, you become a fool. That means whatever you do is useless. I'll come back to that. But we see wisdom. Speaking aloud. And bringing a voice to everyone who can hear. Wisdom is calling on us. Let's go to chapter 2 now. No, verse 20, sorry, verse 20, chapter 1. Wisdom calls aloud outside. She raises her voice in the open squares. She cries out in the chief concourses and the openings of the gates in the city. She speaks her words. What is wisdom doing? Wisdom speaks in crowded streets. That means wherever you go, in a crowded street, wisdom is there. And wisdom speaks. It's loud in the streets. Have you wondered that in the streets where people are many, everybody's talking and everybody's loud, sometimes there are no wisdoms? Sometimes you miss wisdom. Because everybody wants to talk. And everybody wants to be heard. Then who are you going to listen to? And so in the midst of the streets, in crowded streets, wisdom is crying. Wisdom speaks in public places where people gather to take care of this life business.
So,
wherever you go, wisdom speaks. Wisdom goes to the city gates where the leaders are transacting official business and it speaks. So there is, no matter where people are, they need to hear wisdom's call. Why is wisdom calling? Why is wisdom shouting? Wisdom will always draw attention of those who want to listen. And so wisdom will continue to shout. So it is important for you always to pay attention and to hear what wisdom is shouting about. What is wisdom saying? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at the people that wisdom talked to. To whom does wisdom speak? Look at verse 22 of chapter 1 of the book of Proverbs. How long will you simple ones, will you love simplicity? For scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Simple ones are naive people who believe everything. When they hear any teaching, they are there. simple. Listen to me. They don't take those words. Look at how wisdom is searching for you. Say wisdom. Say it again, wisdom. The simple ones, they are the men pleasers. They are yes and yes, men and women. They don't interrogate why I'm saying yes. They are the simple ones. Number two group. That wisdom is falling home. Scoffers. Those who think that they know everything. I don't know where you are. You know yourself. There are those who think they know everything. Wisdom is looking for them. Calling for them. In crowded streets. In the gates. Whenever they are doing business. Don't think you know everything. And they think they know. They think they know everything. There are people that when you start making a statement, they finish it for you. And when you ask them, what did I say? They are not even reciting back. They have no narrative at all. But they know everything. Even in this church, there are people who know everything.
Your view.
Even if it is nothing. say you don't know, you are not going to tell us anything. You tell us nothing. That's our homies.
Manu and one table.
He's right.
And just one.
He knows everything.
Okay, more and more.
Now wisdom is saying. When you think you know everything,
so be proud of being ignorant.
He calls you proud. He calls you arrogant. He calls you a scoffer. That's what wisdom calls. He says, what you think you are, that is not what you're supposed to be.
He
says, I am wisdom. When you know me, then I'll give you everything. God is present. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many are listening? How many are following? Say, I'm not a scoffer.
I'm not a scoffer.
I'm not single. A scoffer wears a sneer all he contorts. Have you ever seen people contort when you speak this? Do something like that. The Bible calls you a scoffer. Wisdom calls you a scoffer. How I pray that you will receive the wisdom of God. And stop being a scoffer. That's a sign of pride. May God help us. And wisdom is speaking to the third people. Fools. It's a word that nobody wants to be referred to. But listen, people are ignorant of the truth because they are dumb. Not lively or spirited. There are people who are stumbling. They have a set purpose, all opinion or resolute. Where he fixes his mind, that is where he. There is what people say that people bury their heads in the sand. Let me refer to that context. When you bury your head in the sand, you think that is where you are. What I know is what I know. And it is outside the word of God. You are a fool. That's too hard, but I'll say it again. When you think that what you know is what you know, you are stubborn. Even when we tell you,
education.
Oh, you can be a fool even if you went to school and you have a degree. That necessarily does not mean that your IQ is low. All you have poor education. You only hate knowledge. The moment you hate knowledge, the revelation knowledge of God, you are a fool. I can't even hear amen there. Don't give me amen because you are not a fool. But I'm talking to believers. I know I'm helping somebody.
I'm gonna